Okay, class, shall we stand and let us pray. Almighty Father, you're the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. God, we thank you for today. Thank you for the blessings, protection, and guide us. Lord God, please give us the knowledge of wisdom, open hearts, and presence of mind to understand our topic for today. This is we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Good morning, class. So, it's nice to see you today. Okay, class, who's absent for today? None? Very good. So, before our discussion, who can remember our topic last meeting? Just raise your hands if you want to answer. Yes, Ms. De La Cruz. Very good. Our topic last meeting is all about the gifted and talented learners. So before our discussion, let's have some activity. I will show you a video presentation and I want you to cooperate and participate. You just need to follow the instructions and do the procedures. It's called the Mental Age Intelligence Test. Okay, class, so let's read first our objectives. Okay, class, thank you for your participation. So now, let's proceed to our discussion. So, who has an idea about our topic for today? Based on our activity. Yes, Ms. De La Cruz. Yes, it's right. Because our topic for today is related to intelligence. So, what is intelligence? Anyone? Okay. Intelligence is the ability to acquire and apply knowledge and skills. But exactly, our topic for today is all about Binet-Simon Scales of Intelligence. So, who knows about Binet-Simon Scales of Intelligence test? Is there anyone? None. Okay. So, first, let's know about who is Binet and Simon. Alfred Binet, born on July 8, 1857 and died on October 18, 1911 in Paris, France. His real name is Alfredo Binetti or Binet. He was a French psychologist and he is known for what he invented as the first practical IQ test or the intelligence quotient test, which is the Binet-Simon test and later on became the Stanford Binet Intelligence Scale. His parents are Edward Binet and Moina Allard Binet. His wife is Lori Balbiani and they have two daughters. Alfred Binet gave up his position at the Salpêtrière Hospital in 1890. Instead, he devoted his time and carried home experiments with his daughters named Madeline Binet and Alice Binet and observed behavior as responses in a systematic approach. Alfred Binet was a member of the Free Society for the Psychological Study of the Child. He also volunteered at the Laboratory of Experimental Psychology. He graduated at Paris Law Faculty, one of the biggest and well-known university in Paris, France. He received law degree in 1878 and he is a PhD in Natural Science, Sorbonne in 1892. His influence on the field of psychology is that Binet was tasked with finding a way to distinguish children with cognitive impairments to ensure they received the educational services they needed. And then he quickly realized that some children were able to answer more advanced questions that older children were generally able to answer and vice versa. It is based on his observation. Binet was primarily interested in what we could probably nowadays call social intelligence. His major purpose in developing his intelligence tests is to help diagnose mentally deficient children. The roots of modern intelligence tests began in 1890s in Paris, France, when Alfred Binet and his colleague Theodor Simon was hired by the government officials in Paris to devise a test to identify which dull children would not benefit from regular classes to receive special trainings. The first modern intelligence test in IQ history was developed in 1904 when the French Ministry of Education asked these two researchers, which is Alfred Binet and his colleague Theodor Simon, to develop a test that would allow for distinguishing mentally retarded children from normally intelligent but lazy children. Because even then, someone had perceptively noticed that teachers' judgment of students' ability were biased by such traits as docility, neatness, and social skills. That some children were placed in schools for the mentally challenged because they were too quiet, they were too aggressive, or had problems with speech, hearing, or vision. At first, Binet tried a number of tests that failed. Binet observes seemed that normal and dull students were not particularly different in hand squeezing strength, hand speed in moving 50 cm, the amount of pressure on the forehead that causes pain, detecting differences in handheld weights and reaction time to sounds or in naming colors. But when he began to measure the ability to pay attention, memory, judgment, reasoning, and comprehension of the children, he began to obtain results. In 1905, Binet and Simon developed their first in a series of tests designed to measure intelligence. It was simply called the Binet-Simon Scale. The scale included 30 tasks required students to follow commands or repeat simple sentences. More difficult tasks included constructing sentences from given words or drawing images from memory. This test was given to students in Paris and acted as the reference point for the future versions of the intelligence test. Based upon his research, he believed that intellectual development was a process that occurred over time, that intelligence was not fixed at birth and simply a matter of genetics, but was flexible and could be influenced by the environment to which a child was exposed. In 1908, Binet and Simon revised their intelligence scale and based upon new evidence that a person's intelligence increased with age. The new version of the test was organized according to age levels ranging from 1 to 13 years old. The new version that they developed and organized, for example, it was considered age appropriate for a 5-year-old child to explain how a fork is used, or a 12-year-old children to solve a particular mathematics problem. The child would be given an age-specific version of the test that also included easier and more difficult tasks, indicative of younger and older children's ability. Another given example by Alfred Binet and Theodor Simon is if an 8-year-old boy, for example, passed all of the tasks given for his age but none of the more advanced tasks, it means he would be considered average. One of Binet's significant contributions was the notion of mental age. The concept that children grow in intelligence, that any given child may be at the proper stage intellectually for his years, or else measurably ahead or behind. In 1890, noted American psychologist James Machen Cattle called for the development of tests that would measure mental ability. Stanley in 1978 request was at least partly responsible for the immediate favorable reception to Binet's tests in America. And in 1910, Goddard described the use of Binet's methods to measure the intelligence of 400 feeble-minded in New Jersey children. And in 1911, he summarized Binet's evaluation of 2,000 normal children. The transition from using the Binet test with below-average children to employing them with normal and above-average children thus was complete and successfully. So in general, the Binet-Simon scale of intelligence test is a test for determining the relative development of intelligence, especially of children, consisting of series of questions and tasks graded with references to the ability of the normal child to deal with them at successive age levels. So for your assignment class, in a one whole sheet of pad paper, write your reflection and your learnings about our topic for today.